What's up, everyone? Tapping in for a court chat. Wayzy just wanted to holler at y'all, really, let you know kind of how things are progressing. I'm working on maintaining calmness in my mind. I spoke about maybe saying anxiety that I was going through the other day, and you know, I was digging through my phone, cycling through apps, kind of searching for something. But again, like more often than not, when I find myself in these patterns, the thing and place that I need to turn to is in here. I need to turn to me. You know, there's something that I'm not doing for myself. So like just today, even today, like, you know, I've been stepping away from it. I have been, you know, getting back into writing, and I picked up, you know, a book, made sure that I was slowing my thought process down and stepping away from thoughts that were being projected inwards, I guess. And then, you know, stopped looking through the phone so much. You know, so the book and the writing, again, helped slow the process down and cave that sense of anxiety a lot. I found myself, you know, at the height of this, you know, wanting to turn towards vaping even, and, you know, making that conscious effort to step away from that so that I don't lean on a crutch in a time where I have to work out and strengthen some muscles so that I can move forward without handicapping myself. You know, because anytime that you're turning to a vice, whether it be vaping, drinking, any kind of recreational drug, you know, to help alleviate things that you're not processing, you're setting yourself up for failure and a spiral downward. You know, so again, I was looking to actively step away from those things. Even today, you know, I was making conscious efforts to actually set my phone down, you know, and to, I guess, deal with whatever thoughts are up here in making sure that I'm the one processing my thoughts in my mind and that my mind is not actively conspiring against me. Because while you appear to be all yourself, there's a lot of your makeup as a human being that you're not in direct control and function of. So if you're not taking those opportunities to work out your brain muscles, you know, and deal in that emotional gym, as Orion put it, again, shout out to Psych Hacks. Shout out to Coach too, CGA, Free Agent Lifestyle. Like, I always appreciate tuning in to him. You know, he's definitely been a big inspiration towards me even moving forward with this. So like, I appreciate that. But anyway, moving forward, if you're not stepping into that emotional gym, if you're not taking those opportunities to work on yourself, you know, you're going to miss the opportunity to strengthen those weak points and build that resolve, because those bad days and bad time, it might be a week, might be a month, might be a year, but at some point, something along those lines might bubble back up and surface, and you'll have to deal with it again. You'll have to take that opportunity. But again, the more you choose to work directly on it instead of just avoiding it by turning to substances or whatever, the easier it is to catch it at the start, and then, you know, pump those mental weights so that you're more capable of dealing with that. And again, from wearing that one mask, not having to separate yourself into all these different hats, you know, you'll get to focus on being who you are authentically, and then turn into yourself and be accepting, gracious, and thankful for who you are, and turn some of those weaknesses into strengths possibly. So even today, like, I was dealing with one of my guests, you know, and I found myself leaning towards irritation, and I kind of had to chuckle, because the situation was such where, you know, it's dealing with a third party issue, so there's really nothing that I can do, but I understand that she's having a problem. But she doesn't understand, I guess, how the business works on my side. So in lieu of, you know, taking it personally, I let a little chuckle go, you know, and I just kind of smiled throughout the rest of the interaction, and like I made sure to be helpful, to listen to what she's saying, to validate what she's telling me, but I just know things that she doesn't, you know. And then at some point she ended up disconnecting the call. Of course she was frustrated, you know, but I maintained the polite professionalism throughout the duration, you know. And then she ended up calling me back, and her energy and attitude completely changed, you know, and she was looking forward to receiving the information that I was, you know, actively choosing to try and give her. So again, just having that level of awareness and control can ground you, you know, and it can maybe bring people back into whatever your frame of mind is. Because again, she disconnected the call out of frustration, but she definitely reached back out to me, and she had a different mindset when she called me back, you know. And that is because, you know, she said it herself, she didn't want this to get ugly. I'm like, I'm right there with you. I really want to help, but I'm limited in my capacity on what I can actually do, you know. So that's why I probably appreciated being in customer service and sales, you know, rolling with those kind of particular punches, and then never taking it personal. And then having that, sometimes when I would go home, because I was so on at work, I would go home and like I would try and be on boss status, but I was probably drinking and using during this time frame too. So like that's a huge thing, because when you're using, you know, I had to put on that professional hat when I'm at work, and then when I get out into the streets or whatever, you know, I'm on that user mentality. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not being kind of my authentic self at all times. I'm wearing different masks to blend into certain environments and situations. But probably in that reality, in that time, in that point in my life, I was a functional user. You know what I'm saying? Like I was an active functional user. And when I went to work, I put that happy face on. But outside of that, you know, I didn't have the same value and viewpoint of people that I do currently, because I was using, I didn't understand people that didn't, you know. And then I kind of felt they were being disingenuous. Not that I was kind of hiding something and taking advantage of myself and maybe hiding some pain from myself. So it was a weird turnaround, you know. Leaving that, I was talking to somebody today, you know, like I don't know how long I've been clean, but it's been quite some time, and I have no real interest in really turning back to that, because I left those party days behind for my own reasons. And like I had my fella there. It doesn't suit my interest in lifestyle anymore. You know, I was young and I was free, and I took advantage of my youth, and probably more than I should have. But that is just a lesson that shows you can learn and you can grow and you can really leave things behind once you choose to work on that discipline and let go of things that aren't necessarily beneficial for you, you know. And like all it took was me making a choice, like I just don't want to do this anymore, you know, and like it's not good for me. And like, you know, I could tell, like it was just, I wasn't, it's, you start partying, you're having fun, you're having a good time, but then over time, it's just like, for what, man? It's like, what? And like, I'd rather repeat good days, not high on anything, not drunk, not high, not any of that, because like, I enjoy sunshine. I enjoy getting out and breathing fresh air. Like, I have simple dopamine receptors, you know. I don't need that extra boost, that extra kick. Like I'm authentically me at all times, so I don't need to drink to have fun. You know what I'm saying? What do they say? You don't need shoes to run, but it helps. You know, I'm not against these things. Trust me, under the right circumstances, I definitely might indulge at some point in time, but like it's nowhere near the forefront or even something that I would seek out. So like I'm proud of myself in that light. And again, you know, turning into yourself, becoming more of who you are, strengthening that core, and you know, solidifying who you are and condensing into yourself, those are things that are gonna catapult you in a forward direction, as long as you make sure that you're holding on to that at the core, and that that is your purpose to stay on those tracks. And you know, people can keep up with the train, they're welcome to jump on, but there's terms and conditions for this. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're gonna try and shift what I'm doing from the inside, I can't allow that. I'm definitely willing to help, but you got to be willing to help yourself, because I'm not just gonna keep pulling your weight for you. You understand? So yeah, a little bit of a rant and a ramble today, probably more so than others, but just wanted to tap in, check in with you guys again, give those updates, let you know that, you know, I'm not preaching, I'm just sharing my experiences, you know, and that everybody goes through times, and these are some things that I'm aware of that help me move forward through my time. So I appreciate you guys tuning in. Remember to conduct yourselves in manners that'll help you take advantage of the direction that you want your life to go in, and set yourself for your own success. You know, get your life on track, join that Wagey train, and ride it through to success. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Wagey's out.